Lab is involved in basic and technological research aimed to realize three-dimensional smart materials for regenerative medicine application, and in particular for articular tissue repair. To do this, both the internal architecture, from macro to nanoscale, and the chemistry of such materials have to be finally investigated. Both natural and synthetic polymers have been studied and adopted to realize 3D porous grafts. Different innovative manufacturing procedures have been also tested, like freeze drying, electrospinning, foaming, and stereolithography. Moreover, as bioengineer, I'm interested on the modeling of the scaffold's geometrical and structural features in order to understand how cells decode the chemical physical cues provided by the scaffold itself. The laboratory of tissue engineering consists of about 5-7 researchers, including master's students, PhD, and technicians. The whole work in the lab is highly interdisciplinary, and thus the team covers skills in different fields such as bioengineering, material science, biotechnology, and physics. The lab contains several instruments, including chemical hoods, centrifuges, and histology equipment for biomaterial preparation. The lab is also equipped with optical scanning and atomic force microscopes, where I observe both material prototypes and engineered newly formed tissues. Additionally, we have access to the cell culture facilities and animal factory for biological testing. In this paper, published by International Journal Biotechnology and Bioengineering, we present a theoretical model of a novel scaffold geometry for chondral application. In particular, we have implemented this model with the aim to predict the effect of some geometrical parameters on total porosity, mechanical properties, and permeability of the graft. This model has been also adopted to produce porous polycaprolactone-based graft for chondral tissue engineering application, best unique mechanical and functional features of the scaffolds. Material prototypes were produced with an internal geometry with parallel-oriented cylindrical pores, resembling the anatomical structure of chondrocytes column, besides controlling blood vessel invasion through a limited pore interconnection. The scaffolds have been extensively characterized, and progenitor cells were used to test their capability to support cartilaginous matrix deposition in vivo. Scaffold prototypes showed interesting chondrogenic potential, besides offering adequate mechanical performances, thus becoming a promising candidate for chondral tissue repair, which still represents a serious and widely diffused clinical problem. A very good agreement was found between the prediction of the theoretical model and experimental data. Moreover, many assumptions of this theoretical model, here be applied to cartilage, may be transposed to other tissue engineering applications, such as substitutes.